In this video, we're going to review how to configure and use Midi devices with the EMU app. To configure Midi devices, we need to navigate to a Midi tab and select the given device. First of all, we can see that we receive programs and banks in the bottom right side. We also have a Midi clock synchronization toggle to turn on the synchronization of Midi. So we can see that Midi is synced to 110. If we increase it to 120, we can see it's speeding up. If we increase it further, we can see the animation and oscillators increase their speed, and on the lower left, the master tempo changes. Let's go back to 120. The next option is to select channel for MIDI up tempo sync, so you can manually tap the BPM. Below, you can use MIDI notes on particular channels to change the banks and programs. So for note C-2, it'll be a first bank, and C#-2, there will be a second bank, and so on. We select the first channel here, and the first channel on the Digitech, and we are in the mode. So now we can change the banks, 1, 2, 3. Let's switch to the second channel, where we configure program changes. And again, 1, 2, 3. We have an option to navigate to banks and programs easily with that. Now let's see how we can map particular controls and faders that we are having here on the MIDI C85, 86, 87, 88, and we can see that these values are changing in MIDI events. We can see that the app is correctly receiving it. Let's switch to the third channel of MIDI, not to cross with the program changes previously set, so we can see the channel changed and we can see the different MIDI IDs and values for it. So let's navigate to a MIDI mapping mode. To enable this, we just toggle this button and now we can see which MIDI nodes or values are set to a particular channel or particular fader. So now we have three faders assigned to different MIDI values. Let's do it more extended. Not the exact fader, but we can hold it out and select all faders if we want to map that way. So now we have it under control. All the green channels for this one, and let's do it for the blue channels on that fader. Now we can turn off the MIDI mapping mode and enjoy real-time control for both values. Let's switch to another program and see without any oscillations. So now we can easily control both channels with the MIDI. Other option for MIDI mapping are buttons. We can assign buttons for changing programs. For that we need to press down the program button, previous program button, press click, and the next program button, click. Now we can navigate. Oh, wait a second. You need to be careful because until you select the fader, it'll be mapped for any received MIDI message. Now using the buttons, you can change programs so it'll be more comfortable when assigning each MIDI node with the particular program or bank. And the same for banks. Just use that button while holding the button. Press the MIDI so we can now navigate through banks and through programs. Each bank with four buttons. What we can also do, we can map out one of these faders to master level, which will control how bright the overall output is. Now we can control that one, and all the other options are highlighted in yellow, which can be marked the same way as buttons and master level to any MIDI commands. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more ENTTEC tips or just videos about any of our products, please like and subscribe to our channel.